Hello, I am Sam the Statman, coming at you with another video. Today we're going to be seeing who are the top 10 position players who are playing right now. And for the purposes of this video, I'm going to be ranking them on how good they are right now. It's like how good they were in 2019 and how good they will be when baseball comes back. So like no Albert Pujols, no Miguel Cabrera, those were fantastic players, but they're not so good anymore. Yeah, this is the start of a small series where today I'm going to be seeing who are the top 10 position players, like who are currently playing, and then tomorrow, or the next time I post a video, it's going to be the top 10 pitchers who are currently playing. And without further ado, let's get into it. First, let's take a look at some honorable mentions. Aaron Judge and Francisco Lindor, both are fantastic players. Just didn't make the cut. Really, really close for them, but didn't make the cut. Now let's look at number 10. Juan Soto. In 2019, he batted .282, .401, .548 with a .138 OPS plus. He had 153 hits, had 34 homers, stole 12 bases, and had 4.6 WAR. In his career, he has 7.4 WAR. Not much to talk about. He's a great player. He has a lot of upside. I think he's going to be fantastic in the years to come, but I don't think we've seen enough of him yet. He's only been around for like 2 seasons. In the major leagues, I don't think we've seen enough of him yet to rank him higher on this list. But like after a couple of seasons, if he's probably gonna be a lot higher on this list. Like I would have ranked him higher on this list probably because in a couple seasons we might be looking at one of the best players in history. But right now, it's the same player, but we might recognize him as one of the greatest players in history in a couple years. But now he's a guy who we think is going to be fantastic. I just don't think I've seen enough of him to rank him any higher. Now let's look at number 9. It's Jose Altuve. Now, hear me out. Jose Altuve didn't have a great 2019. He batted .298, .353, .550 with a .131 OPS plus. He had 149 hits, 31 homers, stole 6 bases. But even with that, and he had 3.8 WAR, but even with that, I think you still have to say Jose Altuve is a really, really good player. I know the whole Astros cheating scandal, but he has lots of accomplishments. For example, he won an MVP, 5 Silver Sluggers, a Gold Glove, the ALCS MVP. I'm pretty sure he has won batting titles or multiple batting titles. And he has 36.7 WAR in his career. That is really good, and I think even with the cheating thing, I think he does deserve a place on this list. Number 8 is Anthony Rendon. In 2019, he was fantastic. He batted .319, .412, .598 with a .153 OPS plus. He had 174 hits, 34 homers, 5 stolen bases, and had 6.4 WAR. In his career, he's won 2 Silver Sluggers, made the All-Star team, and has 29.1 WAR. Number 7 is Matt Chapman. Boy, did he have a good 2019. He batted .249, .342, .506 with a .126 OPS plus. So not great offensive stats, but he had 145 hits, 36 homers, 1 stolen base, and 8.3 WAR. This is basically a lot. Is not all of it is based on his fantastic defense, but a lot of that value comes from defense. He is a fantastic defender. He's won 2 Gold Gloves and has 19.8 WAR in a 3-year career. 2 Gold Gloves, 19.8 WAR in a 3-year career, which is actually more than Cody Bellinger has, like, in WAR. He has more WAR than Cody Bellinger has in his career in the same amount of time. So that's a really cool fact. He is really good, and I think he will be on these lists for years to come. If I make it again, like, next year or something, I think he'll still be on this list. Next, let's take a look at number 6. And in my opinion, the best third baseman in all of the MLB right now, Nolan Arenado. In 2019, he batted .315, .379, .583 with a .129 OPS plus. He had 185 hits, 41 homers, stole 3 bases, and had 6.7 WAR. In his career, he's won 7 Gold Gloves, 5 Silver Sluggers, and has 37.5 WAR. A lot of people like to talk about like the Coors effect, and the Coors effect is a thing. It is important to like talk about, but still, Nolan Arenado is a fantastic player. Next, let's look at number 5, which is Alex Bregman. In 2019, he batted .296, .423, .592 with a .162 OPS+. He had 164 hits, 41 homers, stole 5 bases and had 9.1 WAR. He came so close to winning the MVP. In his career, he's had 2 All-Star games, 1 an All-Star MVP, All-Star Game MVP, and 22.4 WAR. Wow. Now let's look at number 4. It's Christian Yelich. In 2019, he batted 329, 429, 671 with a 179 OPS plus. He had 161 hits, 44 homers, stole 30 bases, and had 7 WAR. If he hadn't been on the shelf for some of the year, I think his stats would have looked even better, and he was probably winning the MVP. He has won an MVP in 2018, and his career, he has 31.8 WAR. For number 3, it's Mookie Betts. In 2019, he was great. Not as good as his 2018 year, but still great. He had 295, 391, 524 with a 135 OPS plus. He had 176 hits, 29 homers, 16 stolen bases, and had 6.9 WAR. In his career, he has won an MVP, multiple gold gloves, and has 41.8 WAR. Now let's look at number 2, Cody Bellinger. In 2019, wow, was he amazing. He batted 305, 406, 629 with a 169 OPS plus. He had 170 hits, 47 homers, stole 15 bases, and had 9.1 WAR. He won the MVP. In his career, he's won an NLCS MVP, the MVP this year, Rookie of the Year, and he has 17.3 WAR with 9.1 WAR coming this year. That WAR may not sound like a lot, and Matt Chapman does have more, but in the coming seasons, Cody Bellinger is just going to dominate. And, I'm basing some of my, rankings off, how good are they going to be in the future. So that's why I put Cody Bellinger at number 2. And number 1, you guys all knew who it was, it's Mike Trout. In 2019, he batted 291, 438, 645 with a 185 OPS plus. He had 137 hits, 45 homers, stole 11 bases, had 8.2 WAR, won the MVP. And that's not even his best season. In his best seasons, he's had nearly 11 WAR, 10.8, I think, in his best season. He's won 3 MVPs, the Rookie of the Year, and has 72.8 WAR in his career. That's the video. I hope you enjoyed it. And don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. I'll see you guys again soon. Bye.